In this segment, we're going to talk about linear regression. And we're going to see what the background of how we derive the linear regression method formula is. So we're not going to be deriving the linear regression formula. We have done that elsewhere. But we're going to look at the background for how we come up with developing the linear regression formula. Again, the linear regression formula is that we want given x1, y1, x2, y2. So we're given several data points, n data points. And what we want to do is we want to best fit. We want to best fit y is equal to a0 plus a1x to the data. So what we're trying to do is that somebody is giving us n data points, where x is the y is a dependent variable, x is the something called the explanatory variable, and somebody is giving us n data points like this, let's suppose, and they want us to best fit this straight line here. So let's suppose if this data point here is xi comma y sub I. So I'm just taking I as a general point which is given to us. The value of y at this particular point will be simply a0 plus a1 x of I, because this straight line is nothing but a0 plus a1x. That's what this straight line is. So the error which you are getting, what you want to do is in linear regression is that you want to, or any kind of regression model, is that you want to minimize this error. So this error which you are getting, e sub I, or residual, I should say, people call it a residual. Residual is the difference between the observed value, which is y sub I is the value which is observed, which is given to you, and the predicted value, which is a0 plus a1x of I. Or I can just expand it, I get y sub I minus a0 minus a1x of I. So that is the error associated with each point. Now, we cannot say that, hey, maybe I can change the straight line and then I can minimize the error at this point here. I can always make a straight line go through this data point. Then the error associated or the residual associated with that particular point will be zero. But it will change the errors or the residuals at other points. So it looks like that maybe I should not be looking at a specific point to make this error or this residual to be small. I should be looking at all the data points at the same time. All the residuals I should be looking at the same time. So people could say that, hey, why don't you do this? Why don't you just use this as a criteria of minimizing the residuals? So you simply, what you do is you take all the errors which you are, or all the residuals which you are getting at all the data points, and you simply go ahead and add all of them up, and you try to minimize that. You try to minimize this sum of the errors. And it looks like to be a good, decent criterion to use. Now, let's see what the problem with that one is, or if there is a problem with that kind of a criteria. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this to an example. So let's suppose somebody gives you data like this. Says x, y, at value of 2, it is 4. At 3, it is 6. At 2, it is 6. And at 3, is 8. Okay. So let's suppose somebody is giving you these four data points and says, hey, why don't you go ahead and use this criteria of summing all the residuals and minimizing that. So if I draw this, I'll get 2 comma 4 is, or if I show the plots, 2 comma 4 here, then 2 comma 6 is the third data point, which is right here. Then I have 3 comma 6 here, and then I have 3 comma 8 right here. So I'll have 3 comma 8 right here. So those are the four data points which are given to me. And what I want to do is I want to minimize the sum of the residuals there. So someone will say, hey, why don't you go ahead and draw this line? So if I draw this line, let's suppose, then this line here, by using my knowledge of trigonometry or geometry, what I'm going to get is y is equal to 4x minus 4x minus 4. That's what I'm going to get as the equation of that line. Because simply, you are drawing the straight line between 2 comma 4 and 3 comma 8, and this is the equation which you're going to get for that particular straight line. Now what I want to see is that does that straight line minimize the error? I'm just taking this straight line by faith, so please don't think that I've already found out the straight line which minimizes this error. I'm just taking one of the straight lines which I could draw. I could draw infinite kind of such lines there. So if I want to write down this table again, then I got x here, I got y here, and I'll write down the residual right here. maybe not write down the residual there. Let me just write down what I predict there, and then I will calculate my residual. So I can say, hey, what is y predicted, and what is the residual? So I get, if this, the values are 2, 4, 3, 6, 2, 6, 3, 8, for example, and y predicted at 2 is 4, because you can just calculate that by using the formula 4x minus 4. The y predicted here is 3 times 4 is 12, 12 times 4 is 8, that's 8. Then 2 comma 6, the predicted value is 4, and at 3, it is simply 8. So I'm just getting these predicted values by simply substituting the value x into this formula of 4x minus 4. So what is the amount of residual here? 0. Here the residual is minus 2. Here the residual is plus 2. Here it is 0. And if I sum the errors, I is equal to 1 to n, what do I get? I get 0. So that seems to be a good straight line to use, because the sum of the errors, sum of the residual which I'm getting is 0. So, but how about this? If I choose y is equal to 6 line, that is also a straight line. It is going through these two points here, but it's not going through this point and this point here. And in that case also, as a homework, you're going to find out that for y is equal to 6, summation of the errors, summation of the residuals from 1 to 4 of e sub I will be equal to 0. So what you are getting is that this, using the summation of the errors as a criteria, is not a good criteria, because you are getting this 0 error, or this as small as possible error, but at the same time you are not getting a unique line for showing that, hey, this is the line which is going to suggest that, hey, I'll best fit the curve. Now somebody might say, hey, why is that important? The reason why it's important is because if you're going to use this as a criteria, that you want to minimize the sum of the residuals, you're going to use that as the criteria to find your straight line, people are going to get different lines. Some person is going to get y is equal to 6, some person is going to get y is equal to 4x minus 4, and there are infinite other lines for which the sum of the residuals is going to turn out to be 0. So what that means is that the summation of the errors itself, this here, is not a good criteria.